In 1945, the challenge of World War II was answered through the defeat of a great evil, an achievement that endures as one of humanity's greatest legacies. 2 years later, the heroes of America's greatest generation had left war behind and returned to business. This story begins with one of those heroes, Roy Patterson, and the enduring legacy he built by holding firmly to a singular vision and values. This is The Flanders Story. Evansville, Indiana, a bustling port city on the banks of the Ohio River, was enjoying the post-war business boom. Roy, a graduate of F.J. Wright's High School, had worked at a local motor service center in his hometown through a high school co-op program. After graduation, he joined the U.S. Navy, where he was enrolled in an electrical apparatus repair training program at Purdue University. While pursuing his engineering degree, Roy served as the chief electrician aboard a repair ship in the South Pacific during World War II.
When I went aboard the ship, the engineering officer put his arm around me and he said, "Roy, I've been praying for somebody like you." Now, if he only knew what I really knew, he'd have kicked me off the gangplank right there. But I was a chief electrician. If there was an electrical problem, it was mine. And I blacked the ship out a few times. Anyway, we didn't sink it.
In 1947, Roy joined Flanders Electric Motor Service, located in Evansville, Indiana. His experiences in the Navy had him well prepared for the new job.
With the experience I had, I could rewind AC/DC, troubleshoot, welding, and I did all the machine shop work at Flanders Electric.
By 1962, Frank Flanders, the original founder of Flanders Electric, was in poor health. Roy and his partner, Bud Havens, purchased the business, maintaining the original name. Their vision reached far beyond the usual concerns of business. And that vision was realized by two basic principles that remain the cornerstone of Flanders. Love others, and treat them as you would want to be treated, and serve others. From the very beginning, the main focus of their small motor repair shop was on providing unparalleled service to their customers in the surface and underground mining industries.
One morning, this gentleman in a three-piece suit come over and walked in, told me who he was. He was the manager of the Westinghouse shop in St. Louis. And he looked around, he saw three of us, and he said, "I don't know how you do it." And I said, "Well, we... nine employees," and he said, "Well, I only see three." I said, "Well, we work three shifts, that's nine employees."
The small business underwent a period of rapid growth and expansion. The original facility, located at 1301 East Missouri Street in 1969, was succeeded by a new shop a few blocks away at 1050 East Maryland Street. To meet increasing customer demand, there were six expansions over the next 10 years. Another driving force behind the growth of Flanders was their focus on constant improvement, doing it their way, and doing it better.
There were a lot of coal mines in this area, and they had pump motors, and we did a lot of repair on pump motors. We learned to make them last a little bit longer than the average shop did, and that helped us grow our business too. It's just things that you do because you know you have to. And I've got a devious mind anyway, and that helps with coming up with things that haven't been done before.
In 1974, Roy and Bud's sons, Dave Patterson and Jim Havens, bought stock in Flanders and became co-owners.
My interests in high school were mainly about cars and girls, but mainly cars. And that transferred into the electric motor repair business because it is mostly mechanical. I really enjoy the mechanical aspects of the electric motor repair business. I remember Flanders being very, very much service oriented. If the customers needed something over the weekends or even holidays, we would do everything we could. Yes, customer service was our main goal. It was instilled very early, but also Flanders already had a knowledge of how to do the repair work, so the quality was also impressed upon us very strongly.
By the time Dave and Jim joined Flanders, the company was poised to broaden its customer base considerably.
We were very, very much mining-centric at the time I came into Flanders. Strip mining, open pit surface mining in this part of the country was just booming. There were other industries that I was interested in, metal industry. We have a large aluminum plant just north of here, Alcoa, and I was very interested in that because I had studied a little bit of metallurgy in college, and that interested me.
And with the broadening of their customer base and the continued provision of unmatched service, Flanders enhanced its tradition of round-the-clock service.
In 1974, we started second and third shifts. There was a dual purpose there. First, a lot of our customers, especially industry and mining customers, ran three shifts. So we were there to take their calls and to give them service during those periods of time. The second thing that these shifts added to was the capacity. We could add people without adding a lot of infrastructure and equipment.
Ongoing success demanded additional expansion, and in 1981, Flanders opened a new headquarters on Baumgart Road on Evansville's north side. The new facility allowed space for Flanders' new engineering division.
One of the things I think that's helped Flanders evolve is that we learn how things break, so to speak, and we can use those in our designs and our new motors and new technologies. In the beginning of the 1980s, we discovered that having an engineering department would really enhance our motor repair capabilities. Having our engineering group gave us even a better advantage than the OEMs because we worked closely with our engineers. Quite often that was a disconnect between the OEMs, the engineering staff, and the motor shops didn't always collaborate well. We started out being one family to begin with.
And as Flanders evolved, its mission evolved as well. Flanders has been and remains focused on balancing success in business with social good. Flanders understands that their success is based upon their customers' success. And they realize that focused innovation is the key to operational efficiency and reliability, leading in turn to customer success. With their focus on ensuring the success of their customers through innovation, quality, and service, Flanders' unique approach to business sets them apart from their competitors, as much as the quality of their work and the unmatched service and warranty they provide their customers. In 1985, continued customer demand led to another expansion, this time in Marion, Illinois.
We were learning a lot about the newer technology at that time, so that we could apply that technology, the lessons we've learned during a repair, and come up with our own motor designs that are higher quality and higher performance.
In the early 1990s, Flanders drew upon the strength of their experience and innovative drive to begin manufacturing complete custom motors for their customers, backed by one of the best warranties in the industry. And in 1998, the company broadened its reach still further by opening field service and engineering offices in Longview, Texas, and Casper, Wyoming. In that same year, realizing that Flanders could provide even greater service, they filled another unmet customer need by beginning to distribute some of the finest motor and electrical component manufacturers in the world. The company added still another field service and engineering center in Lakeland, Florida in 2000. In 2006, Flanders' dedicated engineering group began building and selling products including AC and DC drives and other control systems. Flanders became a third-generation family-owned company when Dave's sons, Alan, Joe, and Doug, joined the company. In 2004, Alan was named the chief operating officer.
The term family business, to me, means that you treat employees as if they were your own family. I think that attitude and that demeanor naturally exists here because the ownership, we're all family, and we also consider our fellow employees part of the Flanders family. We've strived to maintain the things that have made Flanders successful. We've made a conscious effort to capture those and to document what sorts of things really are unique about the Flanders culture that our competitors or other companies don't have or aren't successful with. Most of the people at Flanders are not in it for themselves, so to speak. They're really in it for the customers, they're in it for their teammates, and they're in it for the overall success of the organization. My leadership will be similar to my grandfather and my father's in that the customers will always be important. Their needs will continue to be our focus as an organization. In addition to that, the way we've treated people, we've always treated others as if we would want to be treated. And that's something I certainly want to not only maintain, but grow within the organization.
With continued growth and facilities across North America and as far away as South America, Africa, and Australia, Flanders needed to change their internal structure.
What we've tried to do in the reorganization is maintain that focus on our core services, repair, field service, our sales, our training offerings to our customer, but also make sure that we're putting enough emphasis on new technologies, our new products, our new motors, so that we give those groups a chance to flourish and be successful.
The company reorganization has been an ongoing process. 4 or 5 years ago, we were primarily a motor repair facility, and we made new motors and had some engineering work. As Flanders has grown, we recognize that a lot of our really explosive growth has come through new motors, engineering opportunities, automation, technology improvements, and that was the reason for the reorganization. And, you know, as we grow and evolve, it's going to continually change.
Recognizing that the reorganization was an indicator of a fundamental evolution in the company's identity, Flanders rebranded itself in 2012.
The rebranding of Flanders has been an interesting process. It's helped us a lot identify who we are and how we got to where we are now, and then who we want to be in the future. That's been a part of our mission and our vision, and then capturing all that in one message that not only our customers can identify us with, but we can identify with ourselves.
Our goal is to provide high quality, reliable, cost-effective solutions, motors, drives, controls, intelligent systems for our customers. We're engineers, we like doing that, but we also like serving the customer. And we believe we can offer much, much higher quality and reliability.
The Flanders story is one of success through hard work, superior service, and unmatched quality. And by holding firmly to the vision and the values that formed and continue to guide the company. But what lies ahead?
We are the largest ESA repair shop in the world, and I have confirmation on that. I think because we are, we have the best service and the best quality and the best price. And I think that's why we've grown to the size we are.
In the next 10 to 20, 30 years, I see us expanding our repair capabilities as well, globally. And I also see us continue to apply the things we learned in the repair industry to enhance and improve our products that we're going to be able to supply to customers all over the world and to original equipment manufacturers, mining equipment, mill equipment, and those sorts of things.
The common thread for sustained growth for the company, I believe, has really been innovation. Our people have a desire, a knack almost, to think of better ways to do things. So I think that really is at the core of our sustained growth. The other thing is our ability to serve customers well. We've always kept that as the number one priority of the company. Really, our main strength as a company, I believe, is that we are very much a service provider. If a customer has a problem or an issue or an opportunity, we're there to serve them no matter what.